Thank you. If you want more information, you can find it at myfox8.com. Just look on the morning news page. You'll find a lot of information for gifts for kids there as well.
You know, it's the season for charitable giving, but do you really know how your money's being spent? Thomas Tighe joins us now with some red flags to look for and how to make a good choice on which charities to give to. Good morning.
Good morning.
I think this time of year, a lot of people just want to do the right thing. We want to seek out charities, but it has become very complex, hasn't it?
Right, you're right. People are encouraged to give at this time of year, and I think it's important for people to give thoughtfully and carefully. I think all that encouragement does create an environment where people can exploit the sentiment. So thankfully, there are resources that protect consumers that allow people to do their own research about which organizations have all the good housekeeping in order, that the finances are published and the organizations are properly registered. And I think that's really important for folks to do as they are encouraged to give, which is important for nonprofit organizations like mine and many others in the country.
As people do research, what are the red flags? What are the things that would indicate a charity is maybe not being run as well as it should?
I think the basic ones is to look at whether an organization on its website, it should publish its audited financial statement. It should have, as we found is important for direct relief donors, a donor privacy policy, which has been very interesting to learn just how much people care about what an organization is doing with its information as well as its money. And also that it's properly registered and is filing its forms as nonprofits are required to file with the IRS. All those things should be readily available on any organization's website. And if they're not there, there's necessarily something bad. It's just a red flag and something to dig into a little bit. Organizations like Charity Navigator or the Better Business Bureau also provide a service of really rating or ranking charities, or at least providing a screen to make sure all the governance pieces are in place. So it's not just a couple of family members or something like that. There's 20 or so indications for the Better Business Bureau that tells you whether or not they've got all those things in place, and that's important, something to look for as well.
So when people have already made donations and then they find out, maybe this wasn't the best organization, is there any recourse, or do you just say, I learned a lesson and I'm going to make sure that my money goes to the right place in the future?
Well, I think there's always a recourse. I think if someone feels that they've been misled, we've had situations where people have called where a member of the family has mistakenly made a contribution to direct relief, or they filled in the wrong number intending it for one of the groups. We always give it back. I mean, it's the donor's money. It's their choice. And that's kind of the bedrock principle, that it's the donor's intention that determines that we must be honored. So I think if folks really feel that they've been misled, it's important to call. If there's questions that arise, you should call or send an email. And a fine organization would do its best to respond and report anything that doesn't seem particularly straight up. I also would never recommend just giving your credit card information to someone who makes a solicitation over the phone. And you hear about those stories, and it's just not consistent with ethical practices or smart practices.
Great advice this morning. You mentioned two resources, Better Business Bureau and Charity Navigator, as being an online resource, and we'll certainly direct people to those. Mr. Tighe, we appreciate your time. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Brad.
One little note, Charity Navigator may or may not give you much information on small local nonprofits. So keep that in mind. Better Business Bureau may have a better bit of information about your small local groups. Take a look.